What's up guys, welcome to a new video on the channel. This video is something I never did before, but this game is something else. Something so different that I want to talk a little bit about it. For disclaimer, the images are all from the first hour of the game, and I'm not going to speak nothing too much spoilery. About the thing everyone wants to know, this game is about connecting people. That's it? Okay, there's more to it, but the premise of the game is that. In more detail, there was a big explosion that messed up the time and space, creating a breach between the world of the living and the dead. After the explosion, because of the Death Strandings, people got isolated, with the fear of going out. Their mission is to connect the cities through a new network, and in the way, deliver supplies and materials. Through the way, you face three types of dangers. A group of thieves, that I don't recall their name at this point, but if they detect you, they will follow you with the intent of stealing your cargo. Rain, there is not normal water, but falling time. In other words, everything it touches gets older and older very fast till the point of death. And with that rain comes the BTs, a type of beings that are stranded to the world of the dead that appear every time you see an inverted rainbow. And that's why the couriers use the babies, that are called BBs, that can see them and sense their presence, kinda guiding you through them. These sections are of pure stealth. You have to move slow, not make a sound, and even making you hold your breath when the BTs are near you. You play as Sam, that is Norman Reedus, one of the people that have dooms. This is kind of a condition that allows the carriers to see or sense the BTs, depending on their level. Sam is a level 2, so he only can sense them. All this is more deep than I'm explaining, but I don't want to give much away. Let's talk a little bit about the game now. The graphics, as you can see, are super realistic. The game is made with a Decima engine, that is the Guerrilla Studios engine, the studio that gave us Horizon Zero Dawn, and we all knew the power behind the engine, but now we see its full potential, delivering amazing landscapes that invite the player to explore the world. The mechanics are very solid, having a dedicated button for each of its hands so you can grip better the cargo, depending on the terrain or the weight you carry. Besides that, you also have a stamina bar, but in this game, it's a very fair one. Something interesting about this game is the connection with other players. There is no multiplayer, and you never see other players, but if someone falls and loses some cargo, and you pass in that place, you will find it, and if you want to, you can deliver it. If some player places a ladder or a rope to pass some area, you will see the ladder or the rope and you can use it. Also, you can leave messages that indicates the way certain dangers that are in that area. It's a pretty cool interaction with other players. It really gives you the idea of connection. And again, that is the idea of the game. For last, I want to talk about the soundtrack of the game. That is the perfect soundtrack for a game. You're walking, hearing the world noises, sometimes just the rain or the wind or a river, and then the music starts playing. A very calm and melodic sound, the angle of the camera changes, and it's phenomenal. It's like playing the movie, just like Kojima likes to do it. Now, talking about if I recommend this game or not, honestly, I don't know. I'm enjoying it a lot. I'm like 5 to 6 hours in it and I'm loving every minute, but I know this is a game that is not for everyone. If what you want in a game is a lot of action and fast pacing, this game isn't for you. Sorry to say it, but it's not. Now, if you're the type of gamer that enjoys exploring, a game with very slow moments holding off story, but well paced and with some action moments, this game is definitely for you. There are some tedious moments, I'm not going to lie, but you always got that feeling that what you're doing is kinda important and have a meaning, a real meaning. It's a very well-paced game with a good and strange story that emerged the player, making you want to continue to more and more. Well, it's a Kojima games. All of his games are a little strange and weird with a lot of cutscenes, but in the end they are just amazing. And with this, I think I'm going to end here the video. If you are playing the game or thinking on playing it. Please tell me on the comments below. I really want to know what you think about the game. And for now, this is it. As always, I hope you guys enjoy the video, and I'll see you on the next one. Stay cool.
Bridges falling.